characters, then he goes on to describe who are the heroes in the Pandava side and who are the heroes in the Kaurava side. So I think it's very important to know the other characters as well, because those are the main characters. The rest of them are just allies. People you will see, some are not very important, but some are important. So let's go through their stories very briefly. Who is this Drupada? Actually, Dronacharya and Drupada. He is the king of Panchala. Dronacharya is the Acharya of the Pandavas and the Kauravas. Drupada and Dronacharya studied under Bharatwaj. So they learned all this, how to use the weapons and everything. And at that time, they were very close friends. And one time, Drupada says, you know, one day I will give you half my kingdom. We will share the kingdom. So maybe he was joking. So then Dronacharya, later he is very poor. But then he remembers Drupada. Oh, this is my friend is there. He can help me. He even told me that he'll share his kingdom with me. So he goes for help. But Drupada at that time, he says that, okay, we were at that time young and we didn't know who we were, but now I'm the king. So I need to be like, I cannot have friendships among non-equals. So he kind of dismisses him and Dronacharya is very hurt. So he wants to take revenge on Drupada. So Dronacharya starts to train these Pandavas and Kauravas, so under the royal family, right? So then what happens is, at the end of it, they have to give the Guru Dakshina, right, to Dronacharya. So he says to the Kauravas and the Pandavas that you have to capture the kingdom from Drupada. Kauravas are unsuccessful, but the Pandavas are able to do it. And then what Dronacharya does is, so he then gives half the kingdom, saying, you didn't keep up your friendship, but I am keeping up the friendship by giving half of this kingdom to you. So then Drupada feels very insulted. Then he wants to take revenge on Dronacharya. So he prays and gets two children directly from the fire. From the fire, Drishtadyumna and Draupadi, they are born. His other son is called Shikhandi or Shikhandini, who is the cause of Bhishma's death. So these two, Drishtadyumna and Draupadi, are born. And Draupadi later marries the Pandavas. Arjuna basically wins her in the Swayamvara. But then Kunti says, share it, all of you share it. So she is doing something. And when they bring Draupadi, she just says without realizing. So because the mother's word is very important, you should never take your mother's word lightly. So she became the wife of all the Pandavas. So Draupadi and Drishtadyumna. So then Drishtadyumna is just born to take revenge against Drona. Even though Drishtadyumna is an enemy of Dronacharya, Dronacharya still taught him. He is his teacher. So now Duryodhana uses this. He says, see, because Drishtadyumna is the captain now. He is the army chief of the Pandavas. And Bhishma is the army chief of the Kauravas at this point. But later it will change. But at this point, Drishtadyumna is the chief and Bhishma is the chief. So he says, see, the son of Drupada has arranged just so that he, you know, sparks this kind of hatred again for Dronacharya, so that he is more invigorated to fight for the Kauravas. So this is the strategy here. This is what Duryodhana says to the Acharya, to his Acharya, Dronacharya. We saw Bhishma and Drona were the banks, right? So Bhishma story we know and Drona story we know. Now Bhishma, why is he in the side of Kauravas? Because he swore to protect Hastinapura. No matter what, he said, I will see the image of my father in whoever sits on the throne of Hastinapur. So even though Dhritarashtra was not the very wise king that should be, you know, in that lineage, he still sees him as his own father and he has to protect the throne. That's why Bhishma, even though his heart is with the Pandavas, he very well knows what is adharma, what is dharma. He knows he's in the side of the wrong and he knows he's going to lose. But still, to protect Hastinapura, he's on the side of the Kauravas. And Drona, why is he on the side of the Kauravas? He is the teacher of the Kauravas and he has eaten from their wealth, right? So he has some duty towards protecting the Kauravas because he was a teacher of Hastinapura for the royal princes. Jayadratha Jala. So we saw Jayadratha last time. Who is Jayadratha? So the Kauravas actually are not 100. They are 102. 100 all the sons of Gandhari and one daughter was there, Dushala. And there was also one more son, Yuyutsu, from Dhritarashtra and another maid. So they are 102. So Dushala married Jayadratha. So that is how Jayadratha is fighting for the Kauravas. And also their enmity was intensified because Jayadratha tried to kidnap Draupadi. And then the Pandavas, they made him his slave and then they released him. So Jayadratha was very, very upset and then he prays to Shiva and he gets this boon that on one day at least, because Shiva didn't give him the boon that he wanted to defeat the Pandavas, but Shiva didn't give him the boon. So he says, no, on one day you'll be victorious. So on the very end day, when Abhimanyu tries to attack the Chakravyuha, Abhimanyu is the son of Arjuna. He goes into the war and there is a kind of formation that only Krishna and Arjuna know. But Abhimanyu, he was in the womb, he heard how to enter that formation. So he enters that formation, but he is not able to get out. And Jayadratha is very, very victorious in keeping the other Pandavas from coming and giving him protection. So that is how Jayadratha, and he is later slain. He is just killed later by Arjuna, who vows to behead him. So that is the story of Jayadratha. And Gandhara Nilotpala. So we know Gandhara Nilotpala, we saw that it is Shakuni. He is the brother of Gandhari. Gandhari is a wife of Dhritarashtra. So for Duryodhana, Shakuni is the uncle. But why he was very upset, basically why he always plays against the Pandavas is because he is very upset with Bhishma and also Hastinapura. So because Bhishma, what he does is he goes to seek the hand of Gandhari for Dhritarashtra. Shakuni objects and says, why is it for Dhritarashtra? It could be for Pandu. So you insulted us by seeking an alliance for a blind man. Later, Gandhari says, I will marry Dhritarashtra. But Shakuni has got that vengeance. So that is why he keeps doing all these foul acts. Shalya Grahavati. So Shalya is actually the brother of Madri, the one of the wives of Pandu, right? One is Kunti and the other one is Madri. So out of Madri is born Nakula and Sahadeva. So Shalya is the uncle of Nakula and Sahadeva. But how did Shalya join the Kauravas? That is because Duryodhana does a plot. He extends his hospitality. When Shalya is coming to be an ally to the Pandavas, he extends his hospitality in the way. And Shalya thinks it is from the Pandava camp and he accepts the hospitality. But actually it's Duryodhana and he knows it. So he is bound to Duryodhana and so he has to fight on the side of the Kauravas. So he says, my weapons will be for you, but my heart and my blessings are always for the Pandavas. So what Shalya does, he plays a very crucial role because Shalya is a charioteer for Karna. And on the last day, Shalya keeps insulting him so much, instigates a wound in Karna. So they say it is very crucial for Karna's defeat. So that was Shalya. Kripena Vahani. So Kripacharya, he is the Rajguru for Hastinapura. So he is the chief advisor. And Kripa, another sister called Kripi. So Kripi married Dronacharya. So he also fights on the side of the Kauravas because he's a Rajguru for Hastinapura. So Karna, we all know, I think. Karna was actually born from Kunti and the sun god. Kunti pleases Durvasa one time when he visits. He grants her a boon. It is a boon that she can give birth to a child from one of the Devatas. she just wants to try it for the sake of it. And when she does it, a son is born from Surya. So that child is Karna. But then later she doesn't know, because it's out of wedlock, she doesn't know what to do. And she leaves it in the river. And he is taken and he is raised by a charioteer. Most of his life he doesn't know. And then later he comes to know that he is the son of Kunti and sun god. But then it becomes too late. Because what happens is Duryodhana extends his friendship and gives the kingdom of Anga kingdom to him. And he becomes his friend. So just for the sake of the friendship, even though in the very end Krishna pleads and Kunti also pleads, saying you are the eldest son of you are the eldest son, so you will become the king. Please come in the path of Dharma. But he says no, now it is too late. So he fights for Duryodhana, even though he knows that it is not right to do so. Ashwatthama. Ashwatthama is the son of Dronacharya. During the war, the only strategy, because Bhishma cannot be destroyed. He has this boon that he can die at any time. So the strategy they use for Bhishma is that they bring Shikhandi, who is like a female. Actually, she is a female who was Amba, one of the sisters, Ambika, Ambalika, and one more sister was Amba. So Bhishma, for the Swayamvara, from the Swayamvara, he abducted these three sisters to get them married to Vichitravirya. So two of these sisters got married, right? The mothers of the mother of Dhritarashtra and the Pandu. The other one was Amba. She was in love with another king. So Bhishma sends her back. But then that king doesn't accept her. He is already out by Bhishma. So she is in the middle and she curses. She takes a vow that she will be the one who kills Bhishma, because she feels that he was the reason for her being ashamed. So this Amba is born later as Shikhandi. So Shikhandi is the female. So they bring Shikhandi as a cover for Arjuna. And when she releases an arrow, Bhishma says he will not fight. And Arjuna starts to shoot the arrows. And then he falls. So that's how they conquered Bhishma. But for Dronacharya, also unconquerable. Like not possible, because he has all these shastras. He is such a great expert. He cannot be easily defeated. So they use a strategy for his son to say that, your son has died. Actually, an elephant died called Ashwatthama. Ashwatthama hata. It's like, so Yudhishthira says this to Dronacharya. And Dronacharya rests all his weapons. And then they are Drishtadyumna. He attacks Dronacharya. So that is the story of how Ashwatthama is in play here. Ashwatthama, of course, because he is Dronacharya's son, he is fighting on the side of Kauravas. Duryodhana, you know Duryodhana. Of course, he is the one who is the cause for all this. So very, very evil and brutal he is, and advised by his evil uncle, Shakuni, of course. So, and then there is one more brother called Vikarna. So Vikarna was the most noble of all the Kauravas. So this Yuyutsu was also noble, the one who was born to the maid. So he changes sides on the first day. On the first day, they say, anybody who wants to change sides can move across. So Yuyutsu, even though he is one of the brothers of the Kauravas, he moves to the Pandava side because he knows what is right and what is wrong. And Vikarna was the third brother after Duryodhana, Dushasana, Vikarna. So Vikarna was the most noble. Going back to the story of Draupadi, Vastaharan, everybody must be knowing that. So Vikar in this court where everybody was sitting, and Duryodhana instructs Dushasana to bring Draupadi and take off her robes. Vikarna was the one who objected, and he said, this is wrong. And he keeps reminding that what you are doing is wrong. So he is considered to be one of the most noble among Kauravas. Who is Drishtaketu? Drishtaketu is the king of Chedi. He is the son of Shishupala. Shishupala is actually the cousin of Krishna. Shishupala was pardoned 100 times because his mother knew that he was going to be destroyed by Krishna. So Krishna says, okay, I'll pardon him 100 times, but 101th time, I will not. So Shishupala insults Krishna in the Rajasuya Yajna of Yudhishthira. So at that time, Krishna releases his chakra and he is killed. But the son was given, Drishtaketu was given the kingdom. Anyway, he was asked to rule Chedi. So he is on the side of the Pandavas. Chekitana was from Dwaraka. He was a Vishni soldier. And later he was killed by Duryodhana. But he saved Nakula on the first day of the war. So he was also a brave fighter. Kasi Raja was the king of Kasi, very valiant hero, an ally to the Pandavas. So Kashi was ally to the Pandavas. Purujit and Kunti Bhoja. Purujit and Kunti Bhoja are the brothers of Kunti. Kunti was adopted actually by one of her uncles called Kunti Bhoja also. So then two sons, Purujit and Kunti Bhoja. So they fight for the Pandavas because they are brothers of Kunti. Saibhya was also a very great archer. He was the king of Sibis. And his daughter, Devika, married Yudhishthira. So that is the alliance there. Son of Somadatta, whose name is Burishrava. You may remember I mentioned that Satyaki's family and Somadatta's family have a feud. So just a short story for you to remember, because if you have more details you have, the more it will stay in your mind. So Somadatta tried to marry Devaki. Devaki is a mother of Krishna, wife of Vasudeva. He wanted to marry Devaki. But Sini, who was the grandfather of Satyaki, he fought with Somadatta because Sini was the friend of Vasudeva. So he fought with him and he brought Devaki to get her married to Vasudeva. So from that time, these two not in good terms. They are against each other. So you know that Satyaki is fighting on the side of Pandavas and son of Somadatta is on the side of Kauravas.